Hi YouTube, I'm designing an open source quadcopter frame. This is the Kestrel. It's named after a small bird of prey about the size of a pigeon or something around there. It's an HD microframe. It's got a suspension like the Acrobrat with a little grommet in there, but I'm trying to be more lightweight than the Acrobrat. My prototype runs on 1106 motors, and we have a little Caddx turtle in here. It's not only open source, but it's also parametric. It's designed using something called OpenSCAD. It's kind of a programmer's CAD tool. You write code, you know, ifs, loops, for loops, while loops, and you take differences in unions and various other operations of basic shapes to come up with a complex shape. And parametric means that you can punch in different numbers for different parts. Like here's a couple of arms. You can punch in, if you want 1408 motors, you punch in the 1408 motor spacing, or the 1106 motor hole spacing if you want 1106 motors. You can specify the length of your arms, the angle, and how wide the arms actually are. The first prototype was too heavy duty. It's, you know, everything looks about right in the CAD, and then you see it in person the very first time you cut it, and this was way too heavy and too sturdy. I'm at about 45 grams or so with all the hardware. That's about 10 grams lighter than the Acrobrat. I'm hoping to shave another 4 or 5 grams off, but we'll see where it goes. The Kestrel has individual replaceable arms. I figured that was a good idea because then we can try out various arm geometries very easily. I want to get the front arms as far forward as possible without actually seeing the props in the HD footage. And I can go quite a bit farther forward. I was being conservative and using the specs of the RunCam Eagle with its 170 degree field of view to keep the props back. But I think the turtle and the split are more like 140 or 145 degrees. So these could probably go quite a bit farther forward. The current prototype is built using the components from my Full Speed Leader 3 micro drone. It's a bind and fly. I had a Crossfire Nano in there. All that stuff moved over. Those 1106 4500 kV motors and an F4 flight controller. Smart Audio 600 milliwatt VTX and my Crossfire Nano are on here now, and I used a Caddx turtle. This is about right now 128 grams. It goes up to 189 grams with a 450 milliamp hour 4S pack, and that flies for about 3 minutes of pretty aggressive freestyle. And if you go up to a 650 milliamp, it runs more like 5.5 minutes. I'm surprised how long it flies on the 650. I've tested quite a few configurations in the CAD for different arm geometries. The motor mounts line up pretty well when you put in the motor spacing for 1106 and 1408 motors, but it also goes up to big old 2306 motors. They look a little silly with these skinny arms, but you can punch that in too. I'd like to see a 4-inch Kestrel, but I don't really want to build one. I was thinking it might be interesting to use the parts from the Iyashin Tyro 79. It has a 1607 2800 kV motors, I believe. It was only about $80 for the kit. I'd just swap in the frame and throw some 4-inch props on it and see what it does. I bet we can get a 4-inch HD quad with the vibration dampening suspension in under 250 grams, but I don't know for sure. I'd like to see. This is the current iteration of the prototype. I've made a lot of improvements up in the front end here, and I've loosened up the suspension a bit. I might have gotten a little too loose. The prototype I'm flying, it's too tight. I don't even think I'm getting any vibration dampening, but this should be better. I cut this one last night for my friend Brian. He's going to be transplanting his Diatone GTM3 onto one of these. He's got a turtle at the house waiting to go. We'll see how that goes. Why am I scratching my head on camera? I don't have a lot of flight footage. I don't have a lot of good flight footage. The weather hasn't been cooperating with me. It's been cloudy, cold, or windy. These little micros don't like the wind. My big 680-gram freestyle quadcopter doesn't care if it's 15-mile-an-hour winds all that much. But this thing, if it's more like 10, it's all over the place. It's every little gust carries it somewhere. The design's open source, so you could cut your own frame. It's hosted on Thingiverse. I'll put all the links to all this stuff down in the description. It'll be down there somewhere. Yeah, I have a CNC machine. I can route out some frames, but my production capacity is pretty limited. It takes about a half hour or 45 minutes of machine time to make one frame. Probably goes a little quicker if I'm assembly lining it, but I'm not really prepared for that. I'd like to get some of these frames out in the wild, though, and get some testing going on. So if you've got an interesting use case, get in touch with me. Leave a comment, get on Discord and talk to me, and let me know what you want to do. I'm interested in seeing some different configurations, something different than I'm doing, something different than Brian's doing. Yeah, just something different. I hope this gets to a point where it's worth going into mass production. I have no idea how to do that, but I'm willing to figure it out. If you think I'm on the right track, if you think the Kestrel's an interesting drone, I'd love it if you'd get the word out for me. Share this video with your friends. Tell people about it. Send people the source code from Thingiverse. Like the video. Subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Twitter. I don't know what else you can do. Read my blog. Come talk to me on Discord. All that's great. Every little bit helps me. I'll post all the links to the source code, the blog posts, the how to find me on Discord, where our Discord server is. All that stuff is going to be in the description. So you have a good day. I'm going to hit stop here.